going to start with topic organic compounds. What are organic compounds? What are their features? Why organic chemistry is studied as a separate branch of chemistry? All these are concepts which we will describe today in detail. Fine. First thing, what is organic? Organic word is clear that it is related to living things. Initial times it was considered that compounds like which can be obtained from living things can't be prepared in lab. It was under vital force theory. Vital force theory was given by Berzelius, which states that all organic compounds are having life, and the compounds which can be obtained from living organisms can't be prepared in lab because they need some mysterious force for their formation, which is not possible in laboratory. That's why we can't prepare organic compounds in lab. But after that, Wöhler was a scientist who was doing his experiment in 1828. In his experiment, he was doing reaction of potassium cyanate with ammonium chloride to make ammonium cyanate. But by chance, ammonium cyanate was overheated and it leads to urea. Urea is a compound which is found in human waste. So the compound which is present in living beings can be prepared in lab. It gave a start to organic compounds by Wöhler, that organic compounds can be prepared in lab. After that, formation of organic compounds in lab started, and now in a year we are preparing thousands of new organic compounds in lab. So the definition changes. Now organic compounds are compounds of carbon and hydrogen or their derivatives. Derivatives may include some heteroatoms like sulfur, oxygen, halogens, etc. Compounds which are not having hydrogen but have carbon, like carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, they are not organic compounds. Organic compounds are those which are having carbon and hydrogen or their derivatives. Compounds like, if you are saying CCl4, it is also organic compound, but it is not having hydrogen because it is derivative of methane. We are preparing CCl from by reaction of methane with chlorine. It is a substituted product. That's why need not to be confused. Organic compounds are those which are having carbon and hydrogen. Organic compounds can be divided into two major categories, that are saturated and unsaturated. Saturated are those which are having carbon-carbon single bond. They are also called as alkanes. See how they are prepared. If you are having one carbon atom, it is having 4 electrons in its outermost shell. It is sharing 4 electrons with 4 hydrogen atoms. Hydrogen is completing its duplet. And carbon is completing its octet. It can be drawn like this. This is CH4. This is first alkane, CH4. After that, if you have two carbon atoms, you have two carbon atoms. right, four electrons. These four electrons are representing four electrons which are present in outermost shell of carbon. Now share it with hydrogen. This hydrogen is completing its duplet. And carbon is completing its octet. In this way. So it can be written like this. It is CH3, CH3, C2H6. So second alkane is C2H6. Similarly, we can proceed with three carbon atoms. When you are having three carbon atoms, draw four electrons over all the carbon atoms. In this way, carbon is completing its octet by sharing three electrons with other hydrogen atoms and one electron with other carbon. This carbon is completing octet by sharing one electron with two hydrogen atoms and two electrons with two carbon atoms. This carbon is sharing one electron with this carbon and three with hydrogens. Complete duplet of hydrogen. In this way, you can write this is CH3, CH2, CH3 or C3H8. So third alkane is C3H8. See this structure in which you are sharing electrons. These electrons are shown in the form of dots. This is called electron dot structure. Right? This is bond structure. This is compressed formula. Compressed formula. And C3H8 is molecular formula. Similarly, you can take out the structures of other hydrocarbons in this alkane series. If you are having four carbon atoms can be drawn in the same way like this. You can show it in the form of bond structure. You can show in the form of electron dot structure as per the requirement. So this would be compressed formula CH3, CH2, CH3 and molecular formula is C4H10. Similarly, if you want to draw five carbon atoms, five carbon atoms means you are adding one more carbon atom. In this structure, you can add one more carbon atom. You have added one CH2 unit here. Just add one more CH2. Then it would become C5H12. If you want to draw six carbon atoms, for six carbon atoms again you need to add one CH2 unit in this structure. As you are adding one more carbon, you need to add two more hydrogen atoms. Then this would be your structure. This is compressed formula and molecular formula will be C6H14. See children, if you see this formulas and generalize it, it can be written like this: CnH2n+2 means number of hydrogen atoms are 2 more than double of carbon. If you have 5 carbon atoms, number of hydrogen atoms are 2 more than double of carbon. That's why its general formula is CnH2n+2. Whenever you got the structure, like you have to draw structure of C6H12, first of all you will see that number of hydrogen atoms are 2 more than double of carbon. So it is what? It is alkane. That means you have to draw all the carbon-carbon single bonds. So start with this, draw all the carbon-carbon single bonds and then complete their valencies. Carbon is having one bond here, so draw 3 more hydrogen atoms. It is making 2 bonds, 2 more hydrogen atoms. It is making 2 bonds, 2 more hydrogen atoms. Making 2 bonds, 2 more hydrogen atoms, like this. So it is making one bond, we will add 3 hydrogen atoms. Very simple. In this way, you can draw the structures of alkanes. Carbons can be split into two types: those which are containing carbon-carbon double bond and those which are containing carbon-carbon triple bond. Carbon-carbon double bond containing compounds are called as alkanes. Compounds containing carbon-carbon triple bond are called as alkynes. Let's talk about alkanes first. If you have 2 carbon atoms with 4 hydrogens, see how to draw the structure. You will take 2 carbon atoms with 4 electrons. This carbon is getting 2 hydrogen atoms. This carbon is also getting 2 hydrogen atoms. Now if carbon wants to complete its valency, it is not having any alternate. So what it can do? It can share this electron also in between these 2 carbon atoms. Right? So what will happen now? This carbon hydrogen bond is single bond, but this carbon-carbon bond is here a double bond. Means carbon-carbon is sharing 2 pairs of electrons in place of 1. Hydrogen is completing its duplet and carbon is completing its octet, like this. So it is structure C double bond C with the 2 hydrogen atoms. We can write it as CH2 double bond CH2. It is C2H4. After that you have 3 carbon atoms. For 3 carbon atoms, see, if you are having 3 carbon atoms, you have 4 electrons on them. Alkanes are those which are having number of hydrogen atoms double than carbon. That is, they are having formula CnH2n. So if you are having C3, means you will have 6 hydrogen atoms. Now try to manage the structure with 6 hydrogen atoms. How you can do? We'll write here 3 hydrogen atoms, 4, 5 and 6. Now if carbon wants to complete its octet, it has to share this electron also in between the 2, like this, and complete the duplet of hydrogen. Complete octet of carbon. It is carbon-carbon double bond. There is formation of carbon-carbon double bond by sharing 2 pairs of electrons. So its structure would be CH3, CH double bond CH2. That means it is C3H6. right? If you have four carbon atoms, you have C4H8. Four carbon atoms will write, one double bond will come in between, then complete the valency of hydrogen atoms. It's like this. Okay, you can write like CH3, CH double bond, CH, CH3. And after that you have C5H10. It can be drawn like this. Five carbon atoms with one double bond in between, then complete the valency. Carbon is making one bond this side, so three hydrogens. This carbon is making three bonds, one more hydrogen. This is making three bonds, one more hydrogen. So this carbon is making two bonds, two hydrogen atoms, like this. This carbon has to combine with three hydrogen atoms. Structure would be CH3, CH double bond, CH, CH2, CH3. It would be C5H10. Next is C6H12. If you have six carbon atoms, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Make one double bond in between, then complete the valency of hydrogen atoms. This is CH3, CH2, CH double bond, CH, CH2, CH3. This is C6H12. After that, we can draw the structures of alkynes. Alkynes are those which are having carbon-carbon triple bond. Their general formula is CnH2n-2. Number of carbon atoms and hydrogen atoms, see how many it is. If you are having three carbon atoms, number of hydrogen atom will be 2 less than double of it. So 6 minus 2 will be 4, right? If you are having two carbon atoms, C2H2, then fill C3, it would be C3H4. If you have C4, it would be C4H6. If you have 5, it is C5H8. If you have 6, it is C6H. We have two carbon atoms with 4 electrons over them. But now we have only two hydrogen atoms. How these two carbon atoms can complete their valencies? This is one way that these two electrons have to be shared in between the two. And these two electrons also have to be shared in between the two. That means carbon will make carbon-carbon triple bond here. Right? So, hydrogen is completing its duplet. And carbon is completing its octet. It would be C triple bond C with two hydrogen atoms. C2H2. If you have three carbon atoms, for three carbon atoms we have to make one triple bond, right? This is one hydrogen. This carbon is making already four bonds. This is 3 plus 1, 4. This carbon is making one bond, so three hydrogen atoms will come this side. So its structure is HC triple bond C CH3. Its formula is C3 H4, four five carbon atoms, sorry, four carbon atoms. We have to make one triple bond. This carbon is making one bond, so it needs three hydrogen atoms. This is also making one bond. It is having three hydrogen atoms. This carbon is making four bonds. This is making four bonds. So it is CH3, C triple bond C, CH3. Formula is C4H6. For drawing the structure of C5H8, draw five carbon atoms. There is one triple bond. Then complete the valency of all the carbon atoms. It would be CH3, C triple bond C, CH2, CH3, right? After that, its formula is C5H10. For C6, six carbon atoms. Six carbon atoms with one triple bond and complete the valencies. It would be CH3, CH2, C triple bond C, CH2, CH3. It was C5H8. It is C6H10. Please do the needful correction. So till now, what we have learned, see it in brief. Firstly, we have started with alkanes. Alkanes are having formula CnH2n+2. So we posted the values and find out it was CH4. C2H6, C3H8, C4H10, C5H12, C6H14. And for alkenes, it was CnH2n, formula was CnH2n, and for alkynes, formula was CnH2n-2. So from all this, what we can conclude, whenever you got any compound, like you have C5H8, you want to draw the structure. How to start? First of all, you will see that whether it is alkene or alkyne, you have to see. Now it is having 8 hydrogens and 5 carbons. Number of hydrogen atoms are 2 less than double of carbon. That means it is alkyne. When you will have to draw the structure, you have to take 5 carbon atom long chain. Alkyne means you have to draw one triple bond. After that, complete the valencies. Just see, this carbon is making 4 bonds, this is making 4 bonds, this is making 2 bonds, this is making 1 bond, like this. Very simple. So you can write it in the form of compressed formula. Right? It can be written like this. It is C5H8. Okay? So, you can pick up any compound and draw its structure very easily. Say you have taken C6H12. How to proceed? It is having number of hydrogen atom double than carbon. So, what you will do? You will take 6 carbon atom long chain. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Double bond you have to draw. Take it in the center and then complete the valencies. All the carbon atoms should have 4-4 bonds. Right? So this is CH3, CH2, CH double bond CH, CH2, CH3. It is C6H12. Okay? Names of hydrocarbons. first thing you have to notice is how many carbon atoms does it contain. If it has one carbon atom, you have to write word root myth. For two carbon atoms, ith. For three carbon atoms, prop. Four carbon atoms, but. Five carbon atoms, pent. Six carbon atoms, hex. Then you have suffix. Firstly, we will write primary suffix. Primary suffix is for carbon-carbon single bond, it is in. For carbon-carbon double bond, it is in. For carbon-carbon triple bond, it is ein. So, how to write the names? One carbon atom with carbon-carbon single bond. All the alkenes are having carbon-carbon single bond. Alkenes are having double bond. Alkynes are having triple bond, right? So we'll write meth plus ene. Its name will be methane. Two carbon atoms, ith plus ene, ethane. Three carbon atoms, prop plus ene, propane. Four carbon atoms, but plus ene, butane. Five carbon atoms, pent plus ene, pentane. Six carbon atoms, hex plus ene, hexane. Right? Then alkenes. Two carbon atoms, ith. Double bond, ene. Now what can come in your mind? Why it is not having one carbon atom? If it would have only one carbon atom, with whom it will make double or triple bond? That's why you can make alkanes with one carbon atom, but you can't make alkene or alkyne with one carbon atom. Then you have three carbon atoms, prop, double bond, ene. Whenever you have to write the name, like suppose this compound is given to you, you have to write the name. You have to see how many carbon atoms built. Then see its formula, C4H8. That means it is having double hydrogen atoms than carbon. So it is alkene. Alkene means you have to write ene. Alkene. Ene. So it is butene. It is pentene. It is hex plus ene. Hex ene. Right? Then for alkynes, you are having eth plus ene. Ethyne. Prop plus ene. Propyne. But plus ene. Butyne. Pent plus ene, pentine, hex plus ene, hexane.